RS Commander provides all necessary tools to correctly create dimensions for a technical drawing. Find these tools in the section Annotation in the Home tab or in the Annotate tab. These tools are easy to use. They are very intuitive. For example, you can easily create lines, parallel dimensions, as well as narrow angles, diameters, radii, etc. In this tutorial series, we teach you how to create and save dimension styles in addition to using different standard and annotative styles. As we can see in this example, the drawing is shown at different scales, while the graphical appearance of the dimension is the same in all views. This is because it's a unique dimension style, in this case an annotative style. It means that we shape the final appearance of the dimension, the size that will be printed, regardless of the scale that we are viewing. On the other hand, the annotative dimensions and annotative objects generally allow you to define the scale to be displayed. As we can see in the example of these dimensions, which appear only in the detail view. Something that can also be seen in the A and B texts that are annotative objects, shown only in this other level, regardless of the layer to which they belong. For more information on this topic, don't miss our video showing the differences between annotative and non-annotative styles. Today, all dimensions as well as texts should be annotative. But for some reason, many users not yet utilize these elements, which are an effective time saver when creating and modifying technical drawings. Before we dive into the characteristics of the annotative dimensions, we must learn to master the standard dimensions, because then making them annotative is easy. In this example, we have the styles standard and I, which are of the types non-annotative or standard. We know this because they have an icon in the form of a crossed out A. The annotative style displays an icon with an A, indicating precisely that it is annotative. To create a new dimension style, we simply click Dimension Style here. We also have this option in the Annotate tab. Here are the same styles that we saw before. When we select New, we will create a new style. Look at this table. Besides being able to write a new name to this new style, we can also choose to copy parameters of an existing style. This means that all the parameters that appear in the new style will be identical to the style we have chosen as base. This option allows us to save time when we want to create a style similar to an existing one. We choose the style ISO 25 and name it Example. This new style will be used in all kinds of levels, since we can also choose a specific group of levels if we like. Press OK. We are now working on the new style. As you see, it indicates that it is not annotative. In these sections, we will be able to configure each parameter included in the dimension style. At this time, the dimension style in use is ISO 25. We know this because its name includes a small arrow. Now select the style and press Activate Example to activate it. The style in use cannot be deleted, even those styles that have dimensions associated with them. Instead, we can delete the empty dimension styles. We can also select the icon Differences to compare the two styles of the existing levels to see their differences. In this example, the styles Annotative and Example. All dimensions that are in this drawing style belong to ISO 25. Note that I select and confirm that they belong to the style ISO 25. Now we can change, for example, the style called Annotative. In the drawing, we see that the appearance of dimensions has changed. Let's select this one and change the style to Standard. Like this, we can have a dimensional drawing with different dimension styles. But how do we modify the visual appearance of a dimension? We have to know that each of the dimension styles' parameters can change. Like that, we can customize the look of the dimension that best fits our needs. Please check out our YouTube tutorials to learn more about dimensions and their parameters in RS Commander.